And steam? And
not create steam, but to soften the wood as the tang comes out. It can sometimes tear out, and the water helps wet the wood so the tang comes out easier without chip out. Chip out is something you really don't want, because you have to then repair it. These are coming out great. These frets were glued in, probably with hide glue, by the way it's coming off of there like sand. And so each and every fret slot has to have all the hide glue, you can see there, cleaned out before it can be refretted.
And you've done that with the first two frets, right?
Yeah, I've cleaned those two out so far, and I've only got what, another 18 to go or something. But these are the things you don't know in the beginning, which companies glue their frets in and which do not. Martin doesn't glue their frets in. Taylor does not glue their frets in. Obviously, Gibson, this guitar was made out of the Bozeman, Montana plant, and Ren Ferguson was running that plant. He's a great luthier, and the fact that they used hide glue is a tip of the hat to the way things used to be made. And some people believe that helps the tone, the hide glue. Many times super glue is used. I use super glue a lot. And when you heat it up, you'll see a puff of smoke. I saw no puffs of smoke on this, so this is a... the glue is crystalline. It's crystallized. Therefore, I know it wasn't an aliphatic resin glue like Tight Bond, or, you know, which most of the rest of the guitar was made with. It's just time consuming. Don't be in a rush. That's when problems happen. So I will just spend the next day or so cleaning out these frets, and then when I go to refret it, I'll be a happy camper.
And so now the frets are in.
Frets are in, leveled, crowned, and this is the final buffing of them. I'll go through four different grits to make them all look shiny like this and smooth. It should feel smooth.
It really is a labor-intensive process.
It is, but it looks good when it's done. Mm-hmm.
Fretted. Mm-hmm.